Esnik made me rage. Like a rage boy. Well, he didn't really, but he was looking at Gurada Linux and that distribution is just the most meaningless pile of doggy doo, because I have to be a little bit careful with my words within the first minute of YouTube for some fucking reason. Oh, I said the F word. Well, 10 minutes into it and I'm already like bubbling on the inside and my nerd boner went away and I just fucking did. Again, I need to watch my language according to YouTube. Disclaimer, I never had a problem with my I never get demonetized for my language. So any of you out there being like, ooh, about me saying the F word once in a while, never hurt my channel. But anyway, I'm going to talk about why alternative kernels are BS. They're bullshit. And before you get all angry at me, oh, can't you, fat fucker? Don't you know that it's giving me performances better here and there and stuff like that? Well, like Esnik says in his video, it's debatable. I personally have not seen much performance gain in running alternative kernels. And if I've seen performances gain, it's on the cost of anything else. Or not everything else, but some other things. He talks about Esnik that it could be compiling modules. I personally have not had that much problem with that, but I don't compile modules other than for my graphic card, the NVIDIA graphic card, and it seems to have been working the times I've been using alternative kernels, and the Zen kernel, the Lucas kernel, or what the fuck they all are called. I have noticed, and other people have noticed this, that you sometimes lose some I/O performance. It could be copying files, it could be using your network. There's a lot of, like here's the thing. If you get something in one end, you're losing something in another place, most of the time. Not always, but most of the time. And why I'm saying that alternative kernels also are bullshit is that if the Zen kernel or the Lucris kernel or the Serenox kernel or the fucking up my butthole kernel or the I don't have a live kernel was so fucking amazing for the desktop, why is nobody using it other than, you know, this little self-built distribution, or not self-built, but this little distribution maker that takes other people's work and respin it into and call it their own and then put it up there. Because the Zen kernel and all these alternative kernels are only good at one or two things. They are not great for generalized system. Your computer is not a gaming machine. You make game on it, but it has to do a lot of other fucking shit. If you want a dedicated game machine that only do gaming, you go for a Steam Deck, a Nintendo Switch, a Xbox, a PlayStation, whatever the fuck you want. They are purposely built for gaming. And in those instances, you could debate that something like a Zen kernel could be really, really useful. Because you're not going to use the internet that much for database searches. You're not going to connect to different devices, meaning over the ether, having like a NAS server you connect to and all of that fucking shit that often. You're not sharing, you know, your recordings and your project files between computers and all that shit. You're not using it for coding and compiling and research and distribution making and stuff like that. You're just using them for gaming. You have to think about this. When you're using an alternative kernel, you are saying, or you're basically forcing yourself into being a one-trick pony or two-trick pony, meaning that now your computer's really good at gaming, but maybe not so much other places. Or you would have problems in other areas of your everyday computing life. Run with the one that your distribution is giving you. Why? Because they have done a shit ton of research into this, and they are using their own tweaks because they found out that this fits well with our audience. You know, there's a reason why the Fedora kernel is not the same as the Ubuntu kernel. Because the Ubuntu may put more weight into, I don't know, SQL search than Fedora does. The Fedora people maybe want more better file transfer on their system. So they configure their kernel in a different way. I'm just throwing stuff out there in the air here right now. And sadly enough, when I see people using the alternative kernels, because they are either gamers or they bought into this fucking hype that, oh, you should use the, I'm just shitting on the Zen kernel right now because I can remember the name. Oh, everyone says I should use the Zen kernel or the Xenox kernel or what the fuck they're called, because it gives me better game performance. And then they bitch and moan about that they're losing 1 megabit per second by downloading or something like that. I don't know if that's the case, just throwing out, you know, something that could happen. because they reconfigured the kernel to work really, really well there. Or their battery life on their computer just went fucking down the drain, which Linux in general have fucking problem with battery life. But now it's like even worse. I'm only getting 1 hour instead of 2 hours of battery life. Well, you're running an unoptimized kernel for a laptop. And then you can go in and tweak it and stuff like that. Like the Corrado people have something to tweak the battery life. Yeah, but is that then taking away the benefits of running the Zen kernel? Most people have no understanding about why they are running the Zen kernel. They just heard some idiot on the internet telling them to do something. They're like, I like the person, I will run it. Here's the thing, people. Becoming an educated user, okay? Because most of the time, I'm sorry to say this, but most of the time, when you're listening to influencer content creators like me, we are talking half-assed truth. We find something that's interesting, don't do research on it, and we're just throwing out opinions that is not based on fact a lot of the times, sadly enough. If I say or tell you to do something, figure out if I'm wrong. Okay, you just told me to do this. Let me look at if I have links down below. Let me read the links down below what they are saying. Oh, he's saying that the Phionics, that the Zen kernel is more or less bullshit. Let me go and look at all of the benchmark that the Phionics people have done and other people done on the Zen kernel versus the stock standard Ubuntu kernel and the NVIDIA kernel, the Ubuntu kernel, stuff like that. Really easy to find. Just Google Zen kernel benchmark. And you will see where it you know, what you are getting out of it. And I know, you have to do some fucking work, okay? Yeah, I know, you have to spend at least 10 minutes to 30 minutes doing it. But here's the thing, it will help you in the end, because then you can make an informed decision. So you can say, you know what, I'm willing to pay this, you know, penalties to gain something here. You now know what you are getting into. Instead of you're using, you're like, why am I not getting any performances increases? And oh, it's my hardware. It's either too old or not optimized for the Zen kernel. Again, I'm just saying, when I say the Zen kernel, I mean alternative kernel in general. I'm just shitting on the Zen kernel because I can remember the name, like I said before. So don't take this as it's just the Zen kernel that have a problem. It's alternative kernel. So if a multi-million dollar company like Red Hat and Canonical and SUSE and their projects, Fedora, Ubuntu and OpenSUSE and all of that, are spending plenty of time and resources on figuring out how to run the best kernel for a desktop computer, meaning doing what you're doing on a desktop computer, that means that should probably be the best kernel to run. It should give you less hassle, best overall experience. You know, you don't have things that's massively slow, right, and massively good and other things, like, again, with an alternative kernel. It should work the best as a generalized desktop. And I don't care if you're gaming 10 hours a day, you are still using your computer for more things than gaming. Okay, gaming is just one part of it. So you can't just sit there and think about game, because if you have a computer that you only use for gaming, you don't use it for anything else, yes, we can go and talk about alternative kernels. But if you're doing like rendering videos, maybe the Zen kernel or other alternative kernels, I'm like fucking butchering the rendering performance. Maybe it helps it, but then it's butchering your gaming performances. So you have to figure out what is more important to you. And the only way you could do that is to research it. Okay? I'm now telling you that alternative kernels are bullshit. Go and prove me wrong. Go out and research it. Go out and say, I don't think they are. And then find, you know, benchmarks and stuff like that and look at them. And if you're willing to pay that price or willing to live with what the alternative kernels or Zen kernels and all that is providing you, and you're like, you know what, I don't mind this is good enough for me, and you feel that you're getting a performance, even though you may only get 1% performance that you can't fucking see, run it. I'm not saying you should not run it, but at least be informed. I have like a rule of thumb, boop, and if it's not giving me anything, or let me put it another way, anything below 5%, I don't care about. Get 5% more FPS. Get 5% more stable FPS. 5% more battery life. 5%, whatever, because 5%, you know, 1 or 2%, they can be within the margin of error. It could just be you're having a good day, the temperature's right, you know, everything just click on the computer. So now we basically just have 3% you can count on, and those 3% again could be, again, depending on hardware, it could be depending on so many factors. If you go to like 6, 7, 8, 9, 10%, I'm like, ooh, that starts to mean something. See you all later. Bye bye.